It was the 2005 NFL draft, and a young rookie sat alone in a green room waiting and waiting for his name to be called. Projected as high as number one overall, Aaron Rodgers slid to 24 with the world watching.
Do people still bring up the 2005 draft? Oh, you already, you knew that was coming.
Somebody did it today, actually.
Oh, you're kidding.
No.
So people do bring it up. How was it brought up today?
Justin Peele, actually, who's one of my workout buddies, plays for the Falcons, brought it up. You know, it's interesting, like you're talking about, not a lot of people, even my peers, really know me that well. And Justin, he just said, hey, I've always wanted to know what it was like sitting in that green room in 05. That day, as I look back, was one of the tougher days as an athlete, because the whole time you're thinking, man, haven't I put in the time and the sacrifices, and you're just hoping for somebody to pick you. And then as the numbers keep falling down, it was embarrassing. It really was. And then the tough thing is the transition on TV goes from complimentary of a guy you think is going to go in the top 10 to, all right, well, let's start picking on him as he's fallen, because there's obviously got to be something wrong with him. It was a tough day.
Unlike a lot of guys who've been the man, you've had to work for it and you've had to wait for it. Coming out of high school, how many Division I-A teams recruited you?
I got zero scholarship offers. The biggest schools recruiting me were Lewis and Clark in Portland and Occidental College and Claremont McKenna. No offense to them, but I felt like I had more talent than that. I just needed an opportunity. And Coach Rigsby at Butte College gave me an opportunity to compete for the job. And I eventually won the job and had a big year. Coach Tedford came up and watched me do a workout and ended up offering me a scholarship after that. I then got an opportunity to play against Utah and ended up finishing out the last 22 games as a starter. But my road hasn't been the easiest road, but at the same time, I'm not looking for any sympathy for it. I think it's made me a better person. And I actually will quote a little bit of poetry here. It's actually semi-ironic that my favorite poem as a kid was The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. And in some ways, the path that I've traveled has been a path that it's not the most beautiful of the two paths, but in the end, I think I can look back as the traveler did in the poem and say that it made all the difference doing it the way I did it.
That's an awful lot of perspective for 25.
You get a lot of time to think when you're the backup.
What's the best piece of advice you got this offseason? Because I'm sure this year, more than any other, you've had more people in your ear.
Well, I think the best piece of advice was from Tom Brady, actually. I saw Tom in January on a vacation. We happened to be in the same spot, and I was talking to him, and he was the most gracious, kind, nice guy. But for him to take the time and to give me the advice that, you know, now that you've played 16 games, the last thing you want to do is get complacent. He said you need to pick two or three things as you watch the film and study the film from last year of yourself that you need to really work on and improve on those things. And I took that to heart when I got back to Green Bay, and I was very critical of myself, as I feel like I always am, and just picked at a few things I really wanted to improve on.
So all of this waiting to get to this point in your life and your career, is it what you thought it would be? Are you here? Is this what you've been waiting for?
I've been waiting to play football at the highest level and be trusted and counted on and believed in and doubted and cheered and booed for a long time, because that's what it's all about. It's the game, it's competition. That's the stuff I live for. The other stuff, although it's a lot of fun, I've met some incredible people, I think there's a lot of times where you wish you could still kind of be normal and be a very good football player.
Coming up on VIZIO's Profiles, a very good football player shows us how music serves as a very good escape during a grueling season.